due to popular demand, the Tycoon series is back. This new Tycoon was built from the ground up to be as simple, expandable, and secure as possible. I tried to make this new and improved Tycoon as good as I possibly can, and for that reason, it is rather complex and somewhat advanced. But stay with me. I have a ton of helpful videos on my channels to assist you with topics you may not know about or understand, and I also explain the code as we go. I don't spoon feed it. I don't just give you lines of code to write. I actually tell you what's going on and what each line does. So make sure to check the cards in the top right of your screen and the links in the description for some helpful resources to help you understand topics you may not know about. In this series, you'll learn how to make a real Roblox game with object-oriented programming and the component design pattern. And you'll also get some sensible tips and tricks in regards to data saving and other aspects of your Roblox games. More specifically, in this video, we'll do some basic Tycoon setup to make a stable testing platform for future videos where we'll implement buttons and droppers and all the Tycoon things like that. So if you enjoy this video and enjoy the series, make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel. And join my Discord server as well. The link is in the description. But without further ado, let's get started. So I'm here in a new Roblox Studio baseplate with a part that will serve as the base for our Tycoon model. And let's make that model. So I'm going to hover over my part and hit Control G to make a model, which will have the part inside of it. I'm going to name this model template as the Tycoon template. You can name it whatever you want. Just make sure to change the scripts that we make down the road to match that name. And then this part, I will name base because it's going to be the base for our entire Tycoon. Make sure to go to your model, select the primary part, little box, and then click your base so that your model's primary part is the base. That's very important because when we want to move it around, spawn it in, whatever, we'll need that. So now you can take your template model and put it into server storage. So for the initial phase of our Tycoon, we want to have some quick and rapid testing so we can make sure everything is working properly and also just know what's happening. So the way I want to structure our Tycoon is by making a module script that will have an object-oriented class in it that will be required by a single server script, which will, for right now, assign our Tycoon to a player and just make it spawn in. So let's get scripting. I'm going to go into server script service and create a module script. Now this module script will house an object-oriented class. If you don't know about that, I have a video series about it linked in the description and in the card on the top right of your screen. So let's make this class. First thing I'm going to do is rename this module to Tycoon just to make it look a little better. And I'm going to go down to the bottom, rename this to Tycoon. And then underneath the Tycoon definition, I'm going to say Tycoon dot underscore underscore index equals Tycoon. Make sure the spelling is correct, because this is very important. This is a meta method for our Tycoon that basically says whatever the classes, like the table is created with this Tycoon as their meta table, it'll be able to index all of the functions and properties that it has. For example, this function right here, tycoon.new. And this is responsible for creating our Tycoon. And inside here, we'll say local self equals set meta table. And then inside this, we'll put a blank curly bracket, which is a table. If you don't know about tables, I also have a video on that. And then comma after the blank table, we'll just say Tycoon. So this creates a new table with the meta table set to our Tycoon so we can access all the methods inside of it. And then at the very bottom of our new, we want to return self. And right now, all this does is create a basic class, but we want to add functionality. And the functionality will start in two methods. First one is function tycoon init. And this function will be called at the same time as new, like after new is called, we'll call init, but it's separated in a distinct way. While new will only define properties for our tycoon. So for example, our tycoon will have a parameter of the player that owns a tycoon, and in our new function, we just say self.owner, so like the player that owns the tycoon equals the player. So you notice nothing's happening. We're just setting self.owner, and this will just set the table key, and when we return it, it'll keep it there, and this will just let all of our other functions access whatever is happening. But it won't really do anything. The init function will be where we'll have all of our meat, like where stuff gets called, where stuff happens. And realistically, you could put everything in the init function in the new function. But I like separating it because it makes it a little more clear to the reader. So if someone's looking at your code for the first time, they'll know, okay, new is only for definitions. Init is for all of like the meat that's happening. And also for later down the line when we create our component system, all of the components will have new and init functions, and it's good to start now. So I'm just going to leave our init function blank. Actually, we can add a print statement here. Just say print tycoon was initiated. And we also want to have another function that we won't use right now, but down the line we will definitely need it, and that's the destroy function. So we're going to do tycoon destroy. Now it'll also do nothing, but when a player leaves, this function will get called, and we'll define that in a couple of videos from now. But we need to have this function here just to remember that it exists, and whenever we need something that will get destroyed later, we'll add it to this function just so our game is clean and neat. Because if you leave the tycoon after the player leaves, it'll get polluted with a bunch of like parts that aren't doing anything. It'll make your game laggy and potentially buggy or exploitable, and you obviously do not want that. So now we can test our tycoon module script. And speaking of that, I'm going to rename the module script to tycoon. So in service script service, I'm going to hit the plus arrow and create a script. And I'm going to rename the script to server, just because it'll be the only server script that we'll have in our game. And it just makes the name a little more noticeable. And so I want to get a reference to our tycoon module by saying local tycoon equals require script.parent.tycoon. And so now we have our tycoon. We can create a new one, and we can do whatever we want. And we want to create a new one when players join. And we'll do that by saying game get service players dot player added connect, and then we want to connect a function with the parameter of a player that joined, and then press enter. Make sure to have the closing parentheses at the end. Inside of here, we want to say local tycoon, lowercase tycoon, just to add a nice local definition, and it'll be equal to tycoon dot new. And inside the new, we'll send in the player that we want the tycoon to be owned by. And then after we create our new tycoon, we want to initiate it by saying tycoon init. So right now, if we were to play this, you see it says tycoon was initiated. That's obviously what we want to happen. But notice how we create a new tycoon. It returns self, which is a table, but init isn't in self, it's in the main tycoon, and it's still called through the set metatable and the index relationship, which is pretty cool. It allows you to get really nice classes in your game. So let's make our tycoon class actually spawn in our template from server script service, or server storage, I should say, and put it in the workspace. So at the very top of our tycoon module script, I'm going to say local template equals game get service server storage dot template. And then below that, I'm going to make a nice little convenience function, and it's going to be a local function. Keep that in mind. It'll say local function new model, which will take in the model that we want to clone, and a C frame in which we want to clone it to, and then make sure you have the end at the end, and then we'll say local new model equals model clone, and then new model set primary part C frame to the C frame, and then we'll just say new model dot parent equals workspace, and then we'll return the new model. And this is just a convenience function, just to create the part, put it wherever you want, and then return it. And we'll use that in our init function. So let me delete the print, and we'll say self.model. And we're using self.model because we'll need to use this model later. And let's just like name it a nice little name, and we can access it later. And so self.model will be equal to new model with the template of the template we defined above. And I could just say template clone down here, but this is such a generic function. We want to leave it so in case we want to make another model that's not necessarily a template, we can do that. It's just easier to keep it this way and add one extra parameter. And as a C frame parameter, I'm just going to say C frame dot new. Because for right now, it doesn't really matter where the tycoon spawns. We just want it to spawn somewhere. And by saying cframe.new, we'll just say cframe.new 010. So it spawns one stud above the origin, which should work fine. Because later we'll implement an actual spawn system. But for right now, that should work totally fine. And then since we're creating a model, which is, you know, it's in the workspace, it takes up memory, it takes up render distance, whatever, we need to destroy it when the tycoon gets destroyed. So in our destroy function, we'll say self.model destroy. There's a lot of destroying going on, but you know, you need to have it. So now everything should be good to go. Let's hit play. And the tycoon spawns just where we want it, a stud above the base plate, which is pretty cool. And you'll notice the spawn location, the default spawn location, is underneath the tycoon. So I'm just going to move it out of the way. I don't want it interfering with our nice tycoon experience. So that's it for this video. When you now have a nice base to build off of, on our next video, we'll be making the component system to handle all the parts of our tycoons, like the buttons, the walls, etc. And by the way, the code will be in the description if you want it. But I encourage you to follow this video and write it yourself. And if you enjoy the video, make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel. But other than that, I hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.